Hi, let's talk about your coronary arteries. Your coronary arteries are the arteries that serve your heart, and especially that metabolically active myocardium. Now, this is a fairly unusual view of the heart, and what you're looking at here is a supero-posterior, that means a little above and a little behind, view of the heart with the atria removed. And so this is anterior, this is posterior, this is left, and this is right. And we can see a couple of valves here. So here's your tricuspid valve and your bicuspid valve. And here is the semilunar aortic valve, and there is the semilunar pulmonary valve. And what I want to draw your attention to are the origins of these coronary arteries. So there's the origin of the right coronary artery, known as the RCA for short. And here is the origin of the left coronary artery, or the LCA for short. And what we have a pristine view of is the coronary sulcus. So that is the groove that these coronary arteries are riding in. And it's what separates the atria from the ventricles. And so when most people hear coronary, they think of, oh, that relates to the heart. Well, actually, coronary is in reference to a coronal or a frontal section, which is basically what you're looking at from this view with the coronary sulcus. So cardiac is how we refer to the heart. And so we're really talking about cardiac circulation, and that's driven by the coronary arteries. So here we can see an illustration of the heart from the anterior, as well as the great vessels and the coronary arteries, both the right coronary artery, or the RCA, and the left coronary artery, or the LCA. Now, there are typical branches or patterns of distribution from each of these coronary arteries. So, for instance, the right coronary artery comes off of the ascending aorta, and it spawns the SA nodal branch, sinoatrial nodal branch. It also then descends in the coronary sulcus to give rise to the right marginal branch. That right marginal branch is supplying the myocardium of the right ventricle. And then it continues along posteriorly, and we can't see this just yet, to typically supply the crux of the heart, which is giving rise to the AV nodal branch and posterior interventricular branch, supplying the AV node and the posterior aspect of the interventricular septum, respectively. The LCA also arises from the ascending aorta, and it travels between the pulmonary trunk and the left auricle of the atrium and gives rise to two branches. There's the anterior interventricular branch, also known as the left anterior descending, or LAD, that rides down the anterior interventricular sulcus to supply the anterior portion of the interventricular septum. We also have the circumflex branch riding in the coronary sulcus that wraps around a little to the posterior aspect of the heart that gives off the left marginal artery there. So when we're looking at the anterior aspect of the heart, there are really three major arteries that we care about: the anterior interventricular branch, the left marginal branch, and the right marginal branch. Now, when we discuss the RCA and the LCA, keep in mind that there's going to be some variation. So you'll notice that there are these asterisks next to some of these vessels. And these asterisks are meant to indicate that these are typically branches of the RCA. So for instance, about 60% of the time, that SA nodal branch is going to come from the RCA, which means about 40% of the time, it will originate from the LCA. Likewise, about 67% of the time, the RCA is going to supply the crux of the heart, which is going to supply both the AV nodal and the posterior interventricular branch. And what that means is about 33% of the time, the crux of the heart is going to be supplied by the LCA. So here, posteriorly, we can see some of the continuation of the RCA and the LCA, more of the RCA than the LCA, but we can see the LCA coming down as the circumflex in that coronary sulcus. We can also see the RCA wrapping around in that coronary sulcus to give rise to the AV nodal, as well as the posterior interventricular branch. So this would be the most common pattern of blood distribution. We can also see this on a cadaveric specimen, and I really like to show these views because they're a little more true to life and a little more relatable than the illustration. So here we can see the ascending aorta. Here is the right auricle. There's the origin of the RCA. And here we have the SA nodal branch, and then the RCA is going to continue down. We can also see the right marginal branch following the inferior margin of the heart there. A little more of a right lateral view. We can see that RCA diving down, giving rise to the right marginal branch, and then the continuation of the RCA in the coronary sulcus for the inferior surface of the heart. Here we can see an inferior view, or the diaphragmatic surface of the heart. We can see there's where the inferior vena cava drops in. Here's the apex of the heart, so this would be the posterior portion of the heart. Here's the RCA wrapping around. We can see that right marginal branch going off that way. The RCA continues, and this area here is called the crux of the heart. And that's where we have our AV nodal branch dive deep into the fibrous skeleton of the heart to supply the AV node, and the posterior interventricular branch riding down that posterior interventricular sulcus to help supply the interventricular septum. Here's a superior view of a cadaveric heart. There's the origin of the LCA. And we can see the anterior interventricular branch heading down and supplying the myocardium of the heart there. Sometimes this anterior interventricular branch is known as the left anterior descending artery, or the LAD by clinicians. The other branch of the LCA there coming around is the circumflex branch, and that's giving rise to your left marginal artery. And then the circumflex branch continues on to the posterior aspect of the heart. So here we can see a lateral view. Here's the circumflex branch coming down. There's our left marginal artery of the heart. The last thing that I would like to discuss with you is the phenomenon of heart dominance. Heart dominance is defined many different ways by many different people, but it most correctly describes the vasculature of the crux of the heart. Now, we talked a little bit about how variable vasculature may be. We talked about how typically that posterior interventricular and AV nodal branch are supplied by the RCA. And this is a condition known as right dominance. It doesn't always have to be that way. Sometimes the circumflex branch comes down to supply the crux of the heart and gives rise to the AV nodal and the posterior interventricular branch. And that's known as left dominance, when it's the LCA supplying those. We also have a condition known as codominance, where both the RCA and the LCA supply the crux of the heart. Now, why dominance matters is that with left dominance, you would have the LCA responsible for both the anterior interventricular sulcus and the posterior interventricular sulcus. So the LCA is supplying the entirety of the interventricular septum with blood. And any occlusion of that LCA is going to most certainly lead to a massive coronary infarction and the death of the interventricular septum. Now, all is not lost if there happens to be an occlusion of a coronary artery. So when atherosclerotic plaque builds up in the walls of a coronary artery, that's something known as CAD, or coronary artery disease, which we can see here. And this plaque here is starting to narrow the lumen of the coronary artery. Sometimes it may completely occlude the lumen, or it may break off and embolize and then clog up the artery more distally. Here we can see some of the more common locations for occlusions. So the most common location is for the anterior interventricular branch, or the LAD. The second most is for the origin of the RCA. The third most is for the circumflex, and the fourth most is for the origin of the LCA. And so for an individual with a left dominant heart, if they have an occlusion of the LCA or an occlusion of both the anterior interventricular branch and the circumflex branch, then they're losing the entirety of blood flow to the heart. One of the solutions to coronary artery disease is a coronary artery bypass graft, called a CABG for short, C-A-B-G. And the gist of this is that you take a healthy vessel, this could be from a donor or it could be from an individual's own vasculature, which is vastly preferred because there are no issues of autoimmunity. So for instance, they may harvest, if there's good collateral circulation of the arm, the radial artery from the forearm. And then they would take a piece of that radial artery and they would suture it to an area where there is good, strong blood flow, such as the ascending aorta. And then they may continue that beyond the site of occlusion. So this would be an example of a CABG where the RCA is occluded fairly high up in its origin. So if the occlusion is there, this CABG allows the continuation of blood flow past the site of that occlusion. So we've talked about the right and the left coronary arteries, their branches, their distributions, the tissues that they serve, how they might be in terms of variation, and what clinicians might do when things go wrong. Thank you.